Hello and welcome to another round of Pokemon Trading Card Game Online with the Forbidden Light expansion. Today we are looking at the probably most hyped deck of the new format, which is Ultra Necrozma and Malama. So we're gonna give this deck a try. I'm gonna talk a little bit about the way this deck is built, and then we're gonna see if we can win some games with it, what the challenges are. I probably played so far 5 games with it, so not too far in, but I made already some observations. So the star of this deck is Ultra Necrozma GX, a new GX Pokemon from the Forbidden Light extension. It has the attack Photon Geyser, so it does 20 base damage, but then if you discard, you have to discard all psychic energy, and this attack does 80 more damage for each card you discarded in this way. So think about it, 2 discarded, that's 180, 3 discarded, we are talking about 260, so way more than you need. So pretty much 2 discarded with the choice band will knock out most Pokemons. In the worst case, you need 3. And then you have Sky Scorching Light GX. Unfortunately, you can use this only if both players' remaining prize cards is 6 or less, so more towards the end of the game, but then you can put 6 damage counter on each of your opponent's Pokemon, maybe hopefully do these final knockouts. I doubt that we will use the GX attack a lot, because we are also playing a familiar phase, which is a Dawnwings Necrozma from Ultra Prison. And why are we playing this? One, we play it for invasion. Why do we need invasion? So if I go quickly back to Ultra Necrozma, one challenge obviously we have is we need to refill the psychic energy every turn. How do we do this? We use obviously the new Malama. Malama allows a psychic recharge, so once during your turn, you may attach a psychic energy card from your discard pile to one of your bench Pokemon. If you have 3 Malama in play, we can do it 3 psychic energy, but it says bench Pokemon. So somehow we need to figure out, we need to get the Ultra Necrozma on the bench. Then we need to refill the energy, and then we need to bring it back. And Dawnwings Necrozma is our key to do that. We can use invasion to bring Dawnwings Necrozma up, Ultra Necrozma on the bench, attach all the psychic energy, and then have hopefully a floatstone on this guy to bring him back and continue attacking with Ultra Necrozma. But when I played this, it turned out that this guy by itself is pretty good nowadays, that we can accelerate psychic energy. It has Dark Flash, okay, it does only 120, only, but if you do a couple of times 120, that can obviously 2 attacks, you have a knockout. And it has Moon's Eclipse GX, so this is probably the GX attack which I would prefer in this deck. You can only use it also if you have more prize cards remaining than your opponent, so let's say a couple of first turns, we are a little bit back, something gets knocked out, like a Malama. Then we step in here with Dawnwings Necrozma, we do 180 damage, quite a lot. Choice band is 210, again knocks out most stage 1 and basic GXs. And then any effects of attacks, including damage done to this Pokemon on the next turn, we can prevent. So then we can do another Dark Flash, for example, or we come out with an Ultra Necrozma, and potentially we can knock out 2 GXs in a row without getting knocked out, which obviously would give us a huge advantage. I talked about the Malama. What are some of the other players? I play 1 Lunana Prison Star, mainly for Full Moon Star. So let's say at this point in time we discarded a lot of psychic energy and we don't have enough Malamas in play to get them back. Now we bring out Lunala Prison Star, and for each of our opponent's Pokemon in play, we attach a psychic energy card to any Pokemon in any way we like, which is insane. So let's say our opponent has 5 Pokemon in play, we attach 5 energies in one turn, which is obviously crazy. I also have 1 copy of the Mew, which is a good attacker. So if you, for example, want to copy some of the attacks here without bringing the GX out, we can do that, and then 1 Tapu Lele. we have a lot of the standard supporters. Maybe specific here is Mysterious Treasure. It's an awesome, it's an improved Ultra Ball for Psychic and Dragon Pokemon, since we play only Psychic and Dragon Pokemon here, except the Oranguru. This will become handy because we can pick any Pokemon from our deck by just discarding one card instead of two, which we need for Ultra Ball. We even play four Ultra Balls here, just for consistency, two Professor Letters to get the Psychic and specifically the Metal Energy. So one challenge in this deck is Ultra Necrozma requires a Metal and a Psychic Energy to start attacking. We have about three Metal, eight Psychic, and a lot of times we might need a Professor's Letter to pick out that exact Metal Energy and attach it here. Otherwise, typical supporters, Cynthia, Gasma, Lily, and Professor Sycamore Choice Band, one Super Rod in case we need to find other ways to get energy back, four Floatstone, which is obviously important for the Switcheroo, which we need here. And then we have the one Beast Energy. Beast Energy is awesome, that's why it's a Prism card, but we can attach it to one of our Ultra Beasts, and then that could be, for example, our metal energy on the Ultra Necrozma, plus we get 30 more damage. So this is insane, and that's why we only get one of those, and then we have three metal and four, eight psychic energy. So with that, I would say let's dig in and start a game and see what we can do. Again, this deck looks fairly overpowered, but it is actually not. There are a lot of ways to get around this deck. So let's see what we can do. Let's find the deck here. Okay. Here is Necrozma Dormix. Okay, and let's get started. So let's see what opponent we face. We should have a good advantage against any Buzzwall decks, but the computer typically doesn't give us a. So I assume there is a kind of artificial intelligence built in to balance the game and don't give us too much matchups where we are, where the opponent is weak. So this has fire and all kinds of things. I see a coin, which is a Charizard. So let's see what we get here. So we have no basic Pokemon. Not a great start here. Let's see if our second hand gets any better. And I see Ho-Oh. We definitely have some type of fire deck. Okay. Okay, so we have an Inky here. So we took... We had to take two Mulligans. That's not fun. Having said that, we can, I would say, bring out the Inky and then put in the Dawnwing Necrozma. So the reason I do that, we always have the ability to bring this guy out. Maybe it will be actually depending on what opponent does. If he does a Kiawe, maybe we just want to have him to knock out that Inky, but save this guy, and then we have a lot of revenge methods. Let's see what we have here. So here's a Salandit with Scratch and Venoshock, and then we have the Volcanion. Put the Floatstone on the Volcanion. What do we have? So we have a Mysterious Treasure, that's good. That allows us to bring an Ultra Necrozma. We have a Field Blower, that's good. We can get rid of his Choice Band and the Floatstone. And, okay, and he plays the end. So let's forget what we had and see what we get. Boom. Okay, we have a Malamar, which we can't upgrade. Ultra Ball, Sycamore. We probably need to Sycamore here. I don't think we're gonna play the Mew in this game. We could also N, which gives him three more cards, which I really want to avoid. But we have the Field Blower. So let's start with the Field Blower. Get definitely rid of this Choice Band. And I would say I want to get rid of this Floatstone. I really don't care about the Floatstone on the Oranguru, but Volcanion will be a good card to drag out and get him stuck. Okay, we have that Malamar, which we can't evolve in the first turn. We have a Kuzma, which we won't want. We can play the N. I would say we play an Ultra Ball. And just get rid of these guys. We play a bunch of Malamar, so I'm not too concerned. We have two more at least. And with that, I want to get at least one Ultra Necrozma on the bench, right? We have the Dark. Yeah, I think that's the right play here. That guy on the bench. And then we're gonna play Professor Sycamore to get 7 more cards and leave him with his 3 cards. Okay, for next turn we can evolve at least one Malamar. We have a Professor's Ladder, which we probably use now since we haven't done an energy attachment. Another Field Blower, another Mysterious Treasure, which we could get another Inkay. Let's do the Professor's Ladder first and an Ultra Ball. Wow. So let's get a Metal and a Psychic Energy for now. Attach a Metal Energy here, since we definitely will need that. And then let's Ultra Ball for something. We want to get rid of the Psychic, since we're gonna use Malamar to get it back. And I don't know. Do we need the Mysterious Treasure? We might need it. I'm gonna get rid of this Field Plore. Okay. And we can bring out either an Oranguru, but I think I want to have another Inkay in place. So that we can then get in the next turn maybe two Malamar, one with Mysterious Treasure, one we already have in hand. And that's all I want to do. At this point in time, I don't want him to knock out the Inkay anymore. So I'm gonna do an invasion with our Dawnwing Necrozma here. And then we are done for now. We probably want to find a Float Stone the next turn so that we can load up Ultra Necrozma at least with one Psychic, start attacking. And retreat Dawnwing Necrozma. Maybe start slowly charging up for some attacks later. Let's see, so this is 180. So 180 we need. So 2 is 160. So 180, definitely 2 psychic energy would be enough to knock out a Volcanion. Wouldn't be quite enough to knock out a Ho-Oh, so that would require a Charge Spend. And then another Ho-Oh. 190. So 190 is just not quite enough for 2 psychic energy. So we would need to find a Float Stone and a Choice Band, which will be tough. Let's see what happens. Our opponent, however, seems to be stuck. Okay, he does a Oranguru for 1 card. Let's see if he has a N or Sycamore or something. So he has a Salandit. Discard or inactive Pokemon, okay, and he has a Kyogre, okay. So he will fully charge the Ho-Oh, so it will be pretty important for us to knock out the Ho-Oh on the next turn, which will be extremely tricky, but obviously we're gonna try it. So there's an Ultra Ball, which we don't actually need. What we need is this Malamar. What we need is a Mysterious Treasure. And we just discard this Ultra Ball. Let's find a second Malamar. Okay. And then we're gonna play Thins here. And see what we can get here. Okay, we don't have anything what we needed. We wanted a Float Stone, which we don't have. We wanted a... Okay, we can get 2 energies, so let's see here. We can probably do an attack at least with Dawnwing Necrozma, because we can get 2 energies, one attached, 2, but obviously he's not on the bench, so that doesn't help us. Mysterious Treasures, Ultra Ball, they don't help us at this point. Maybe if we get an Oranguru with... Okay, let's try this out. We're gonna do a professor's letter for two psychic. We're gonna attach maybe a psychic to the active. We're gonna ultra ball. It's not enough. I guess we can use an image here. Yeah, I think we can do something actually here. We're gonna ultra ball the Professor Sycamore and the other psychic energy. Bring out the Oranguru. Okay. Put this guy here, and then we're gonna Mysterious Treasure for Mysterious Treasure. And maybe get another Dawnwing's Necrozma, or maybe Sylvanala. This guy probably will get knocked out. We have a... I'm gonna bring out this Lunala, since we have now a lot of energy in the discard pile. Put this guy out, and then let's see if we get something else with Instruct, which we could use. Obviously we don't get anything. Having said that, let's do Psychic Recharge. Two Ultra Necrozma and another Psychic Recharge. Two Ultra Necrozma, which would at least allow us to knock out the Ho-Oh on the next turn. And otherwise there is really nothing which we can do right now. Done. So he will go in the lead with Phoenix Burn for 180. And then we will come back. Okay, let's see what he does. So he can't do 180 unless he has a shot. He can do a steam up, obviously. Okay. Choice band. Okay, he has a choice band. That's okay. We just need to get something out which we can retreat easily. Which is... 3... 2, 2, 2. Okay. We still have the Gasma. So let's bring just out this Oranguru for now. Okay, here's a Floatstone. So that's super helpful. What I would say is we definitely can get two energies to this guy, and then we can do Moon Eclipse. 180. Maybe even with a Cynthia we can get a choice spent on this guy and do a hot knockout. Let's see if we can make this working. Okay. We don't need Gasma since we have that. So let's do the... We don't want to bring the Inky. I think let's just do a Cynthia. Here's a Beast Energy and here's a choice spent. So now we are in a very good position. It saves the beast energy for later. Put this guy on here. I mean, we even had invasion. And then do a psychic recharge here. Do another psychic recharge here. In the meantime, start to load up our Lunala and retreat this guy, bring this guy out, and now we can use Moon Eclipse GX with the choice band, knocks out the hole, and we are protected for the next turn. So let's see if this gives us some progress. Psychic and Gasma. We obviously need to get another attacker ready in order to do some meaningful play here. Let's see what's in the discard pile. So there's one Ultra Necrozma, the Mew. Mew would actually be handy because of the free retreat cost, but... Okay, so he's starting to load up the Salazar. Discard only from your opponent's attack Pokemon. heat plus 110 damage. This effect for each prize card you have taken. Okay, so more prize cards he has taken, this will be stronger and stronger, which is annoying. Okay. So he does another Kiawe, this time on the second hole. Okay, so we need to figure out a way to knock the second hole out. Let's see here. We have a Tapu Lele. If we bring out the Tapu Lele, we don't have any more bench space, so that's not good. I guess we can do only Dark Flash, which would knock out the Oranguru, give us one more prize, then he knocks us out. We can do Guzma and at least weaken him up. Is there anything else we can do at this point in time? Let me see. Anything we can do. Okay. I think I want to... Okay, I want to get this guy actually out. Boom. 3 retreat costs, so this would be hard for him to retreat. And we can do some good damage on it and then see what happens next. This has one size down amount of energy attached to all Pokemon. This might be actually interesting, the size storm here, given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tons of energy in play. So if we do 1, we need 4 on this. We have in the discard pile only metal. Okay, that's fine. For now, we're gonna do an invasion. And we're gonna do a Dark Flash. A Size Storm would give us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 260 damage. That would be actually pretty good. Okay, he has a Guzma in hand. But what is he Guzmaing? These are all just one prize attackers, so he can knock out the Lunala, that's completely fine with me. Okay. And that gives him exactly one prize card, so he's behind. We have the Beast Energy. Let's bring out the Oranguru and see if we at this point in time can draw into some other attacker. We have plenty of energy here. We don't want to attack with the Malamar. We probably want to attack here. We might just want to do... Okay. This, if we return... Okay, I have an idea here. So let's do Tapu Lele and search for supporter card. What do we even have here? You know. So there's another Ultra Necrozma, a Dawnwings Necrozma. No Ultra Necrozma, so it's prized. That's actually annoying. Ugh. Inky, Lily, Gasma. So what do we do here? If we leave this... So this guy just attacked, so he can't attack the next turn. That might be an option. So he would retreat and then bring this guy out. I don't know. Show cards. Let's just get a Cynthia. And I mean, we just might actually attack. Okay, here's an idea. Could we attack with a Tapu Lele? Okay. So, now I need to hurry up. Psychic Recharge. Boom. 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 Okay, let's just attack with a Lele for now. And then we're gonna retreat this guy. Bring this guy out. Put an energy on it. And maybe a Float Stone. And play the Cynthia, since we haven't played the supporter yet. room. And just do an energy drive. 120. Okay, he plays a max elixir. Let's see if he gets it. He lifts it. He needs two fire energy for this attack. And then he can do 150. He would need a choice band. Fire energy and a choice band, so. Okay, he goes for the GX attack. Puts in a Pokemon GX or Pokemon EX. And what? Give me a discard pile. Okay, he can't even use it. So we can knock out this hole and we win. So as you can see, this deck is by no means, I think, a shoe-in for a win. However, if you kind of play it intelligently, you can deal with situations like this. So I think in this case, bring out the Tapu Lele instead of trying to use some other attacker. Gave us definitely the advantage, because on the next turn we would have knocked out one of our guys, still being left with one, and then we probably would have come back. At this point in time, we have so much energies in the discard pile, which we can bring back with Malamar, that energy acceleration wouldn't have been a problem to probably the Ultra Necrozma, which we found. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this game. I certainly will be back with more action, both with a new Ultra Beasts, with Necrozma, probably a couple of variations of this deck, and I see you guys later.